ungrateful peasants! If poetry be the cake of food, then I am its baker! Come back here and untie me! There are wolves, bears! You will be sorry when I am eaten! Who will sing of your deeds then?
Why were you tied up?
A wee misunderstanding between myself and the good folk of the hamlets hereabouts. Your name, good kin?
I'm Eivor of the Raven Clan. And now I've freed you, so go about your business.
Wait! May I inquire? The dulcet timbre of your voice, the godlike strength of your gait. You are a warrior, yes? A lone skiff bobbing on the sea of opportunity. Wait! What is that on the horizon? Adventure! The stars prophesized our meeting. I am the glee woman Aswig the Mellifluous. You have heard of me? No matter. Destiny has made you my muse. I shall follow you with poetry. When danger rears its ugly head, Eivor balks and just stops dead. Fleet of foot and long of gait, O Eivor, do I pray to your fate. This will not make great poetry, Eivor. Eivor, like a mountain goat, toss your hero half a groat. Eivor running from the past with mighty speed to flabbergast. Eivor is walking like a duck. It's like she doesn't give a fa la 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 and a nonny nonny moo. Eivor climbs on top of the world. This will not make great poetry, Eivor. Fleet of foot and long of gait. Oh, Eivor, do I pray to your fate.
Enough. Stop following me.
I cannot, for walking in your footsteps has let me sup at the cup of inspiration. You are my life's great purpose.
Enough. I won't listen to your blabber anymore.
First there was a famine, and now look here, a feast! Fare thee well, Eivor of the Raven Clan. Your exploits will live on in me.
Now I thank you, but please, take your leave.
Fare thee well, brave hero. Perhaps we will meet again.
Gods, I hope not. Malevolence. This land bears deep affliction.
not be seen in this area.
Get us out of the bar.
the other side. Good traveler. What seek you? Perhaps I can help.
All right.
Right. Let me show you something on your map.
Yeah.
this place is heavily guarded.
Let's end this.
Won't let us lose.
Together. Thank you. rippling through the leaves, making Daddy a fortune. Good girl, Lady Trotters. Good girl.
Nice pig.
Pig? You ignoramus. Lady Trotters is a hog. And the most unique and singular beauty.
Should I leave you two alone?
Please do. And not for the reasons you are insinuating. You are confusing her delicate nose with your earthy stench.
Some like my smell. So she's a mushroom hog. I've heard of such rare beasts.
Mushrooms? She sniffs out treasure.
Treasure?
Epin Forest is full of it, and Lady Trotters finds it. Ah! She has the scent! Come, I'll show you! There you go, my lovely! Find us riches, and you shall have sweet red berries for supper! And socks. Bandits leave them lying around and ladies drawn to their own holy stench. Oh, I lost cause. I'm going for a nap. If Lady runs off, follow her, would you? What she finds, we'll share. The socks are all yours.
Run, lady! Find me something heavy and rich. A fine hoard. Good, Lady Trotters. You are the best of hawks. Go, Lady Trotters. Run like Fenriers on your heels. Beast to rival Gullinborsti, Freya's beloved golden boar. Did the dwarves make you too? What I wouldn't do for a beast as clever as you are. Bristle on this beautiful boar's back. I'll protect you, lady. There. The nasty, smelly thugs won't bother you anymore. No. Wake up. Lady Trotter's found treasure.
Did she now? Well, you must have the knack. She does not take to strangers kindly, do you, girl?
Bandits attacked us, but I took care of them.
Bandits? If you hadn't been there, I dread to think. Please, keep all the treasure. Your payment for my sweet girl's life.
That is an incredible animal you have there.
Isn't she? Bramble sharp and gentle as a kitten. Earns a keep and more besides.
I wish I had as good a companion as Lady Trotter's. One of my gods, Freya, had a boar. It is said that the gloom of the murky regions was lighted. Such was the glow from its mane. But Lady, oh, she outshines him.
Aye, she does. I will never find another friend like her. Well, goodbye. Fare safe on your travels.
And you. Happy hunting, Lady. Guards here are vigilant.
of him.
Thank you.
something's wrong. Foul. Curse it.
Standees, two crookers, two lookers, and a wigwag. A young and handsome peasant's daughter, she seizes me, red, plunders my head. Oh, dear me, no. What am I thinking?
The leather face on Twelfth Layer. Latina, we are to sow that. Though sister better than being endless and harmless than your family.
Doc.
What are you doing here in the middle of nowhere?
Ah, a visitor for Chad the Bewilderer, the most radiant and rakish riddler. Do you have the wits to best me? There is cake in it if you do.
For cake? I will answer any mind tease you have for me.
My head is forged with the hammer, hurt with sharp tools, smoothed by files. I take in my mouth what is set before me.
Iron is forged with tools, and a keyhole could be the mouth of a door. A lock and key?
Wonderful. Your wit sparkles. But still, another one. I saw a strange thing, wonderful of shape, singing in a tavern. Its beak underneath stood upon splayed legs that cannot walk.
Thing that sings. A musical instrument. The bladder that whines and wheezes through pipes. Backpipes.
Very good. A tricky one that few but the sharpest needles can sew. Now, the final test. With my roof of tears, I am driven far and wide on my avenging path. When I shake the forest, I rumble the fruit from the trees.
Rain covers the earth like a roof, and the rumble of thunder and lightning can shake acorns from a branch. A storm.
You are brighter than the sky, Lantern. Your wit outshone my words, and such a feat deserves 3 cakes. But unfortunately, I do not have any.
So the cake was a lie?
Do not pout. Have a reward much more worthy of your talents.
Goodbye, Chad. Your riddles were a fun diversion.
Stay a while. Read some more of my scribblings. I might leave this place one day and move to Eskenchester with my riddles.
That brought the Ushal to Sule.
I should be cautious around here.
Hey! I really think I'll kill you!
Your time is come!
Loves me.
Varins!
Must be blocked from the other side. To get on the other side. Perhaps some pretty flowers will get her to. So you have lured me in. Explain yourself.
It's just been a while since anyone passed this way, and I wanted to be sure you would stay and visit.
By pretending to be a pretty young maid.
My mother used to tell me stories, legends of a forgotten king, of magic swords rising from misty lake waters. There was often a fair maiden, lonely and locked away. I fell in love with that sweet fantasy. So much more romantic than a pathetic man, whiling away the hours until death.
A sad shadow play. So where is your mother now?
Dead these last 3 years and buried under the flowers she loved. I wanted to move on, but I cannot bear to leave her.
Your mother would not want you to be so love-starved. Leave this house of grief.
You are right. She was always so happy, laughing and singing. It would break her heart to see me so forlorn. I'll not let sentimentality be the shackles of my soul. I will find work in the village, even meet a girl, and start my own family.
And tell them stories of magic heroes and fair maidens.
Thank you, stranger. You have given me a glimpse of a sweeter life. This was hers. Take it, for it saddens me to look on.
I hope you find what you're looking for. Farewell.
I'm glad you stopped by. It brought me some comfort.
Hey now, hey. How curious.
On the ice, buy a lean horse and a tempered sword. Do these things and be pleased with your lot.
What? Dark spirits torment us now.
That's better.
This area is off limits.
Oh!
What have you got for me today?
All my pieces are good, but that one's very good. Nothing else I can do for you?
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Be well, my friend.
Greetings.
What do you have today? I have to go. See you soon.
So long. Farewell.
Moment.
Tekla, you look like you wrestled a bear. Is something wrong?
Gods, ˌeɪvɔːr. I was robbed on the road between here and Lincoln.
By who? Did you get a good look at them?
They were Saxons, I know that much. A pack of them lifted 4 barrels of my ale and all the coin I had on me. The biggest one pulled me off my horse and stuck his mouth in my ear, said, "Tell Guthban we expected him home soon."
Guthban? That's battlebone in the Saxon tongue. Are you sure?
That's what he said. It's not someone here, is it?
Not that I know of.
I do not begrudge us taking in orphans, ˌeɪvɔːr, but some of these Saxons, we hardly know them. You ought to ask around.
A good idea. You take care of yourself. Let me see to this.
Thank you, ˌeɪvɔːr.
Rowan.
Ah, ˌeɪvɔːr. How's the day, my friend?
I'm well, Rowan. I had only a small question. Do you know anyone named Guthban?
Guthban? Nothing comes to mind. Should I?
It is not a question of should.
Ah. Is it a horse?
No, it's,
A lover?
No, Rowan, it's no one.
You came here to ask me about no one.
Thank you for your time.
How's your raven doing today?
Octavian.
Ah, salve, ˌeɪvɔːr. How are you?
Well, thank you. A question. Does the name Guthban mean anything to you?
Guthban? It's not Latin, is it?
It is a name, I think. But no face comes to mind. I fear it may be a moniker. A false name.
So you came to me? Why would you come to me about a false name? Do you think my name is false?
No. Is it?
I am Octavian. I've always been Octavian. Now, please, ˌeɪvɔːr, this is not a good time for me. I am terribly busy. Good day.
I must take my leave. So long.
Valet, ˈeɪvɔːr.
Tarbin, do you have a second? I was wondering if...
I am Guthpin, ˈeɪvɔːr. It means battle bone. Not the name of a cheery baker, is it?
Not one who bakes bread, no. So, how did you earn this name?
Before I came here, I lived another life. A brutal, bloody life. I served with a gang of mercenaries. I was their weapon, roaming the wilds of England. Did whatever they asked of me, and all they asked was violence. When I left, I laid this sword on the grass and made a vow. I swore never to spill another drop of blood, to abandon acts of violence, to never kill again.
A hard promise for a hard man.
It wasn't, not for me. This life here is all I've ever wanted. I've never been more at peace. This is my doing. I brought all this upon you. It is down to me to fix it.
Tarbin, by threatening you, they threaten my clan. I cannot allow that.
These men are foul, ˈeɪvɔːr. You should not have to fight my battles for me.
Do you not hear me, Tarbin? If they threaten you, they threaten me. So let us face them. Together.
Very well. Meet me outside when you're ready. I believe I know where they will be.
If you wish to face your old friends, I'm ready when you are.
Good. I'll lead the way. I want you to know, should it come to blows with my old crew, I can handle it myself. Forgiving me is all the work you need to do.
There's nothing to forgive. You walked away. They pursued. By axe or by fist, I will do what must be done to protect my clan.
You're living the life you want, aren't you?
Before we are spotted, tell me what I should expect here. Will they attack us on sight?
I shouldn't think so. No. Nothing like that. It's not how Wilf operates. Yes, he's a clever one. And rather kind when you meet him. Makes you feel like you're a friend. Family, even. I met him a decade ago, and he was the first person to truly welcome me. To see some value in me. He told me I had a gift. For intimidation. Persuasion. Violence. Just by the size and strength of me, he knew how to use me.
What do they want from you now?
They'll want me back. They'll want me to be the man they think I am. Monstrous and massive. Wilf and them were the only family I had then. But their love was conditional. Wilf only loves what he owns.
So what do you intend?
I know I won't go back. I don't want more blood on my hands. But apart from that, it's hard to say. Who knows what they have in mind?
Stopping.
That house, there. They're likely within. It won't look like much, ˈeɪvɔːr. But don't be fooled. And don't take Wilf lightly, charming as he seems. The man is a serpent.
I've met plenty of charmers who turned out to be snakes.
I know. Only a warning. Let's go inside.
My boy, as I live and breathe, you got my message, and you brought a friend. Who might you be, Dane? His new leash?
I am ˈeɪvɔːr, and the woman you robbed was one of my clan. That will not stand.
I know. I'm busted up about it. But tell Tekla, was it? Tell her that her ale is some of the finest we've tasted.
I am done with you, Wilf.
But we are not done with you, boy. We gave you food, shelter, ale to drink, riches galore. We made you who you are.
For all you did for him, he repaid you with blood and sweat. Did he not?
You're a fiery one. I like that. But the ink was dried on this deal well before your number arrived in England. If you wish to clear Tarbin's name, I'm happy to help with that. It's only a small matter of cost. Some weeks back, soldiers confiscated my personal wares, shall we say. Tried to confiscate me as well, but I gave them the slip. If you're keen, you could recover my belongings and return them to me. Do that, and your name is clear.
I can't. I promised myself I would leave all this behind, but...
If it will clear Tarbin's name, we will recover what is yours. Where are these soldiers?
Camped not far to the west. A battalion of bloated, brainwashed military men. You can't miss it for the smell.
Wait here, then. We will return before you sprout another pair of horns.
God go with you, ˈeɪvɔːr.
You found it!
I did. Let's bring this back to Wilf.
You handled that better than I would have.
Oh, they have returned.
We have your goods.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Put them there.
The ledger.
Of course. Happy to honor it. My goodness, such a lack of trust these days. It's a dark age, no mistake.
That's it, then. We're done?
Aye. You are free to walk from this place and live as Tarbin the boring breadmaker for the rest of your days. But you, ˈeɪvɔːr, if you ever get tired of the settled life, we could always use a thief with your skills. Think about it.
Tarbin, are you satisfied?
Yes. I cannot thank you enough, ˈeɪvɔːr. I feared the worst when I heard my old moniker, Cuthbert. Hadn't heard it in years. Wrenches up fearful memories.
I imagine. How did you fall in with that bunch?
After my mother died, I sought family. Wilf offered it. He looked at me, took me in and told me who I was. Who I could be. I don't crave that belonging anymore. Among you lot, people accept me as I am. The greatest gift I ever got. Peace.
Many men are calm because they've never known a storm. You weathered the storm and worked through it. That is a rare thing.
That means a lot. Thank you. It's good to be home again. That is, if I haven't robbed myself of the pleasure of calling it home.
Tarbin, in spite of all, you're welcome here. And you owe us nothing but the work you love.
Right. Payment in fresh loaves of bread. I can manage that.
But first, one scrap of your past remains.
Right. The ledger.
Toss it. And purge the past.
With pleasure.
someone there?
Scraps and rags. Heart of stone, and the stench is ripe.
You! How dare you! Crowland's throne belongs only to the one true king of Briars.
If you have a problem with me, show yourself.
We await the Lord of Crowland, trespasser. Leave or die.
I'm not going anywhere until you cowards show your poxy faces.
Insolent ferret! Kill this usurper!
Thank you.
fellow adventurer, need to know the lie of the land? Where is the matter of my fee?
Yes, all right.
Look here. The spot I'll mark on your map. A place I know.
If they see me, this will get messy.
Oh, it's okay. You fake!
Thank you.